Good afternoon. My name is Ron Parrish. I'm the Public Safety Director for St. Lucie County. And with me today, I have Clint Sperber, who is our health officer and administrator for the Florida Department of Health, St. Lucie County. And today is August the 24th, and this is a COVID-19 update for St. Lucie County. Community transmission of COVID-19 remains very high in St. Lucie County, with a daily positivity rate ranging from 21% to 43% over the past week. This is primarily due to the more contagious Delta variant. Hospitals in St. Lucie County have been reducing visitations, surgeries are being postponed, beds are filling up with COVID patients, and more than 90% of those being hospitalized with COVID symptoms are unvaccinated people. Please help us slow the spread. If you are sick, get tested and stay home. The Florida Department of Health in St. Lucie County, in collaboration with the health with Allied Health and the St. Lucie County Board of County Commissioners, has opened up a COVID-19 testing site at the Gwenda Thompson Trades Career Center at 3855 South U.S. Highway 1 in Fort Pierce, Florida, 34982. The testing site will operate 7 days a week from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Monday through Saturday, and from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. on Sunday. No appointments are necessary. The testing is free. For persons with health insurance, Allied Health will bill the insurance company and will not charge a copay. For those that test positive or have underlying health risk, the Florida Department of Emergency Management has opened a monoclonal antibody infusion treatment center at the Havert L. Fenton Center at 2000 Virginia Avenue, Fort Pierce. This facility will operate from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. daily and is able to serve more than 300 patients per day. This state-run monoclonal antibody therapy treatment site for patients diagnosed with COVID-19 or are considered high risk if infected. Of course, walk-ins are welcome, but appointments are encouraged and can be made at patientportal.com. That's PATIENTPORTALFL.com. The administered antibodies help the immune system recognize and respond effectively to the virus. According to treatment guidelines, they should be administered as soon as possible after the diagnosis of COVID. Monoclonal antibody treatments can be prescribed by healthcare providers to individuals 12 years of age and older who have been diagnosed with COVID-19 or who have been exposed to someone with COVID-19 and are at high risk for severe illness and hospitalizations. However, to support Governor DeSantis's initiative, there is currently a standing order in Florida signed by the state surgeon general that allows patients to receive this treatment without a prescription or referral if administered by an eligible healthcare provider. Such referrals are not required at any of the state Florida monoclonal antibody treatment sites, and treatments are available at no cost to patients. To find other locations offering the monoclonal antibody treatments, visit floridahealthcovid19.gov. That's FloridaHealthCovid19.gov. St. Lucie County officials encourage all residents to continue to follow the COVID safety measures set by the Center for Disease Control at the Florida Department of Health, including proper hand washing, social distancing, wearing of facial coverings, and staying home when sick. Again, we continue to urge everyone to get vaccinated, to practice social distance when you can, to wear a facial covering when you can't social distance, and wash your hands. If you are sick, please stay home. Call your doctor and get a COVID-19 test. Again, testing locations can be found online at www.recoverstlucie.org, www.recoverstlucie.org. Today, roughly 55% of St. Lucie County residents are fully vaccinated. While there have been instances of breakthrough cases where vaccinated people have contracted COVID, the vaccine remains your best defense against this virus. All individuals aged 12 or older are eligible to receive the vaccine. A list of vaccine locations can be found at, and again, www.recoverstlucie.org. The vaccine is free. Remember, both Pfizer and Moderna require two shots, roughly 3 weeks apart, while Johnson & Johnson is just one shot. For those residents still dealing with economic hardships from COVID-19, emergency assistance is available by visiting, again, www.recoverstlucie.org or by calling 772-462-1705. And for residents without internet access or lacking computer skills, please visit one of St. Lucie County's branch libraries and the staff will help you get set up. Or you can call the COVID hotline at 772-466-8480 as well as 211. We are not out of harm's way from this pandemic. Please help us slow the spread. And thank you and continue to be safe. Now I'd like to bring up Clint Sperber, our health officer and administrator for the Florida Department of Health, St. Lucie County. Clint?
Thank you, Ron. A lot of what Ron just mentioned, it's accurate. You know, when we look at the virus itself and how it's been spreading, we are in our third wave right now. And prior to coming here, I was looking at the first time that we held the press conference here, and that was March 13th of 2020. And at that point, I was looking at some of our main public health objectives, and all the measures that we were mentioning at that time are consistent today. The one area that I do want to focus on is one of my talking points back then said, eventually when vaccine is developed, to vaccinate everyone in the community who wants to be vaccinated using CDC guidelines. That point back then, March 13th, when we had 8 cases in the state of Florida, I believe none here in St. Lucie County, still holds true today. Ron mentioned that our vaccination the percentage of people in this county are vaccinated is approximately 55%. Those who are eligible for vaccine 12 and up is around 64%. We're not where we need to be at this stage right now. And I'm very hopeful that with the FDA, when they announced yesterday that the Pfizer is authorized for and everybody 16 years of age and older, hopefully that will be a game changer. We have been speaking to a lot of people who have had reasons for not being vaccinated, and this seemed to always rise to the top of the list, that it was only an emergency use authorization. It never had final approval, even though we would explain that the process itself, it did not skip from a clinical trial perspective and reviewing everything, that nothing was skipped. But now that we do have the full approval from the FDA, we are hopeful that our numbers will continue to increase, because from a Department of Health perspective, we know vaccination is how we will get out of this pandemic. So when Ron mentioned over the last 7 days, our positivity rate has been high, and it's been like that for several weeks. When I look at our total numbers, and it's a 7-day average, it's not a full incubation period, it's not a complete trend over weeks and months, but however, over the last 7 days, we've averaged over 300 cases a day. That's never happened before. Our case count in our ages, because we break that up as well, our largest case count is in 5 to 14-year-old kids. And approximately 98% of our cases are in unvaccinated people. So what does that tell us? It tells us that vaccine is effective. There are breakthrough cases, not many, but there are some breakthrough cases, but we would expect that regardless with any type of vaccine. But the numbers are so low, this vaccine is safe, it's effective, and again, we highly recommend it. Ron mentioned our hospital census. They remain full. I was speaking to leadership of the hospitals before coming here. That remains full, and hopefully with the governor's announcement yesterday at the monoclonal antibody site right down the road from here, that will help alleviate the burden that the hospitals have been facing, that other medical providers who are treating with Regeneron to provide extra antibodies and protection in people who meet that high-risk qualification, this absolutely will help. There's a lot of capacity at this location. It is open 7 days a week. It is a state site, available for anyone across the state of Florida, but having it in our own backyard is, again, I'd use the term a game changer, and it definitely can be. Now, clinical trials, they do say that these types of treatment could reduce infection, hospitalization, and death by over 70%, which is huge. With that, also our testing site, he did mention that is open 7 days a week. We highly encourage anybody who wants to get tested to go to this location. It's not the only location in St. Lucie County. There are other outlets, but from a county perspective of us working with the Board of County Commission to contract with Allied Health to open this site, it is definitely being used today. From 9 o'clock to 2 o'clock, there are 237 people who already accessed the site. So we expect that demand to continue, and again, that's a good thing, to know your status. It's helpful, once you do know you're positive, what to do. The messaging that we've been saying for months, literally months and months and months, hasn't changed. If you feel sick, you know what to do. Quarantine yourself. Try to limit the spread. Don't pass the virus on to others. And with that, I will hand it back to Ron.
Thank you, Clint, and thank you all for joining us today on August the 24th for the St. Lucie County COVID-19 update, and please, let's be vigilant in trying to protect each other and ourselves, and making sure that we're following the guidelines that have been provided, and please get vaccinated. It's Clint, important.
Sorry, Clint, we do have a question on Facebook about the antibody treatment. Has that received FDA approval?
So Regeneron has been approved for several other types of treatments, but with COVID-19, it has the EUA, so it's the emergency use authorization, and it has been used. There has been great results of it.
Hi there, this is Gianna with WPBF. I had a question. You mentioned between the 8 kids between the ages of 5 and 14, that's the highest number of COVID patients in general that you guys are seeing right now?
For the past week. Those were case counts that we had of positive cases for the last 7 days.
Okay, so that's not necessarily hospitalizations. That's just who has test positive.
That's correct.
Okay,
just
what about
those who tested positive.
And what about in the hospitals? Are you guys seeing children in hospitals right now, that age group?
So there has been a wide variety of underage people in the hospital. Breakdown of all the cases in the hospitals I do not have, but what I can tell you is a general statement. The trends that we have seen prior to vaccine of an older population who are with with severe complications, that trend has discontinued. The hospitals are seeing younger people who are otherwise healthy.
Gotcha. And you were saying the majority is unvaccinated.
That's correct.
Okay. And do you, you know, as far as the age group with children, do you think a big portion of that is because, you know, the majority of that age group isn't even able to get vaccinated at this point?
I would think that that has part to do with it.
Okay. How are your guys' schools? Are you guys able to update us on the school situation as far as COVID?
So what I can tell you is we work closely as a Department of Health with the St. Lucie Public Schools daily, you know, 7 days a week. We have been prior to school starting on August 10th throughout the summer, and we have worked with them and continue to work with them to, you know, put in as many preventive measures that are out there. So to answer your question, yes, we do work with them. Yes, they are the ones who are identifying the kids, the staff that are symptomatic, are positive, and between their staff and our staff, we help to identify other contacts in classes. So that is ongoing 7 days a week.
They'll be joining us next week.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Again, thank you for joining us today, and this will conclude our briefing.
We'll do a version in Spanish now.
Buenas tardes. Hoy es martes 24 de agosto, y este es el reporte de COVID-19 del condado de San Lucie. La tasa de transmisión del COVID en nuestra comunidad continúa siendo muy alta, y al momento se encuentra entre el 21 y el 43% diario sobre la semana pasada. Esto ocurre mayormente porque la variante Delta es mucho más contagiosa que las versiones anteriores del virus. Los hospitales de nuestro condado han reducido las visitas, cirugías han sido pospuestas, las camas se están llenando con pacientes de COVID y más del 90% de esas personas hospitalizadas con el virus son personas que no han sido vacunadas. Por favor, ayúdenos a detener el contagio. Si está enfermo, llame a su médico, hágase la prueba de COVID y quédese en su casa. El Departamento de Salud de la Florida y el Condado de San Lucie, en colaboración con Allied Health y los comisionados de nuestro condado, han abierto un centro de diagnóstico de COVID-19 en el Wenda Thompson Trades Career Center, localizado en el 3855 sur de la US 1 en Fort Pierce. Este centro estará operando 7 días a la semana, de 9 de la mañana a 6 de la tarde, de lunes a sábado, y los domingos de 9 de la mañana a 1 de la tarde. No es necesario hacer cita y las pruebas de diagnóstico son gratis. Las personas que tengan seguro médico, Allied Health facturará su aseguranza y no cobrará copago. Para las personas que resulten positivas a la prueba de COVID y tengan otras condiciones médicas, el Departamento de Emergencias Médicas de la Florida ha abierto un centro de tratamiento para la infusión de anticuerpos monoclonal en el Haver L. Fenn Center, localizado en el 2000 de la Virginia Avenue en Fort Pierce. Este centro estará operando todos los días de 9 a 5 y tiene capacidad para atender a 300 personas por día. Este centro de terapia monoclonal, lo cual está bajo el manejo del estado de la Florida, es para pacientes de COVID-19 de alto riesgo. Les exhortamos a hacer citas si necesita recurrir a este centro, pero las citas no son obligatorias. Para hacer una cita, por favor, visite patientportalfl.com. Los anticuerpos administrados ayudarán al sistema inmunológico a reconocer y responder efectivamente al virus. De acuerdo con las normas de tratamiento, los anticuerpos deben ser administrados lo antes posible, tan pronto un diagnóstico del COVID es recibido. Tratamientos de anticuerpos monoclonal pueden ser recetados por profesionales de la salud a cualquier persona de 12 años o más que haya sido diagnosticado con el COVID-19 o que haya sido expuesto a alguien con el COVID y padece algo, alto riesgo de enfermedad severa y hospitalización. En apoyo a la iniciativa del gobernador DeSantis, al momento existe una orden del cirujano general de la Florida, la cual permite a los pacientes recibir este tratamiento sin receta médica o sin referido, siempre que sea administrado por un profesional de la salud elegible. Estos referidos no son requeridos en ningún centro de tratamiento de anticuerpos monoclonal y los tratamientos están disponibles libre de costo a las personas que lo necesiten. Para ubicar los centros que ofrecen la terapia monoclonal, por favor visite floridahealthcovid19.gov. Los oficiales de nuestro condado continúan urgiendo a todos los residentes a ser vacunados, a continuar observando las normas y medidas de prevención establecidas por el Centro de Control de Enfermedades y el Departamento de la Salud de la Florida, lo cual incluye el lavado correcto de las manos, distanciamiento social, uso de mascarillas y quedarse en su casa si está enfermo. Llame a su médico y hágase la prueba del COVID. Al día de hoy, aproximadamente un 55% de los residentes de nuestro condado han sido vacunados y aunque hemos visto algunos casos donde las personas vacunadas han contraído el virus, la vacuna continúa siendo el mejor mecanismo de defensa contra este. Todos los individuos de 12 años o más son elegibles para recibir la vacuna. El listado de lugares que ofrece la vacuna se encuentra visitando www.recoverstlucy.org. La vacuna es gratis. Recuerde, ambas, la Pfizer y la Moderna, requieren dos dosis aproximadamente 3 semanas aparte, mientras que la Johnson & Johnson solo requiere una dosis. Para aquellos residentes que todavía estén teniendo dificultades económicas relacionadas con el COVID-19, fondos de asistencia para el pago de alquiler todavía siguen disponibles. Para más información, por favor visite www.recoverstlucy.org o llame al 772-462-1705. Para los residentes sin acceso a la internet o con poca habilidad para usar las computadoras, por favor visite cualquiera de las sucursales de nuestras bibliotecas del condado y el personal estará listo para ayudarlo. Si desea, también puede llamar al 446-8480. Para más información de otros recursos, por favor llame al 211. Todavía no estamos fuera de peligro en la pandemia. Por favor, ayúdenos a disminuir el riesgo y el contagio y continúese cuidando. Gracias.